Why do I have one brow hair sticking straight up again? It's going to be one of those days probably. Because I still want to keep it nice and soft today. But yeah, it's kind of mute already, isn't it? Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, three looks with the Spring Palette by 5050 Makeup. I did a few other videos as well. I did a first impression where I played with this one palette bingo style. I also did an eye swatch video. I will link everything below in the description box and underneath the cards. Go check it out. But yeah, today three looks. I did not go row by row. Well, I kind of did, but it was not on purpose. The first look is really a row. It's this one because I really wanted to do that color combination. And for the rest, I did kind of a purpley look. This is a kind of a pinky look. I did a bunch. So yeah, at the end of the video, I will give you some additional thoughts. And I think that is it, guys. The makeup that I have on my face will be listed down in the description box. Timestamps will be there for all the looks as well. And let me know down below if you have a favorite. That's it. Grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. It's kind of early. Yesterday I filmed my first impression. I also filmed eye swatches. I think they are, they should all be up. I will link everything. I thought, because some shades are pretty fallouty, let's kind of start with the eyes again. We can kind of start with a neutrally look, because I kind of am feeling this row. I don't know if I will stick row to row though, but it was one of the looks that I wanted to do, that row. So I'm going to do that row. I primed my eyes, I have not set anything, and I'm going to start with a fluffy brush and a color called Charmed. And I'm going to place that in the inner part of my eye. Now this is a very, very light color, but now that I haven't done my base, I can kind of really pack it on, you know. It's maybe not really the correct brush for that, but that does not really matter. And I'm going to kind of place it high a little bit as a transition shade. But I do want it a little bit more packed on in the inner corner. So I'm grabbing another brush. A little bit more dense. I don't think this will be a complicated look, because I don't feel a complicated look today. It's not saying a lot though. Let's get another brush for the color called Bonbon. I'm going to place it on my lid as well. And then kind of work it into that first shade here in the beginning. And then pack on a little bit more here in the outer corner. And then just from the outside I'm going to blend in. They basically blend themselves. This is basically kind of the blend that I wanted, guys. I'm grabbing the color Charmed again, which is that very light shade. Just going to make sure that that blend here is good, the way I want it to. Now, because I really, really like... am I going to use the shade Blossom? I don't think so. I think I'm going to leave it as is. What I do want to do, though, is I want to put a Caterpillar in the inner corner. Because I love that. I don't know if that will stay, because I kind of need to do my base as well, but yeah. I like that. What do I want to do for the bottom? I think I kind of want to make it all nice and even. So I'm grabbing the color called Bonbon. I'm going to stamp it on my lower lash line. And I did put a little bit of concealer there, so I don't need to bring my foundation up as high. I'm going to go into the color Charmed, which was the lighter color, and I'm going to blend it a little. Just smudge it out a bit. Yeah, that's cute. Do I want a green eye pencil? I think I do. This is a little bit of a minty. Let me see if I have a minty green. Let's start with a light blue. Yeah, that's too blue, I know. And then a light green lightly over. Is that the color that I'm looking for? Almost. So I'm getting close. That's good. It's very close. I do want a little bit more of that color Bonbon. I'm getting that flat brush again in the color called Caterpillar, which is the green that I put there. On that flat brush, I'm going to spray it and I'm kind of going to stamp it a little bit just on the edge of my waterline, I think. So not in my eye, but just a little bit lower. I think that is it. Shall I do for funsies a dusting of Blossom? Sure, why not? Fallout does not matter. So Blossom is, oh, this one, the very, very fallouty shade. Let's get a very fluffy brush. So it is not that I have a shimmer, but kind of a little bit something, something when the light hits it. I am going to do the same on the other eye. Then I'm going to do my base. I'm going to grab eyeliner, but maybe that's going to be a brown eyeliner. I'm not sure yet. And then I will be back to show you the look just before I put on my falsies. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. So a little bit more presentable. And here is the look just before the falsies. I really, really like this. I am going to put on my falsies and choose a lippy. The falsies I'm going to wear are my Londons, the more natural ones that I have. So let me put those on, choose a lippy, and then I will be back with the finished look. So everything is on and here is the finished look. I like it. I like how it turned out. Maybe I needed to kind of amp up my blush a little bit, but that does not matter. I can always do that. The highlighter I have on is actually the shade Blossom. And it's very, very pretty as a highlighter. So yeah, this was one of the looks that I really wanted to create with this palette. And now that I have done so, I can kind of move on from there. I really like how this turned out. And this is a look that you can really make your own. You know, you can use all the other different colors that are in here to kind of pop in the inner corner. Or maybe just on the lower lash line, you know. Or whatever floats your boat. But I really like how this turned out. And I'm going to feel fabulous wearing this for the rest of the day. The lippy I have on is one from Ofra. It's a long lasting one in the color Miami Fever. Which is also a little bit more of an, I don't know, almost a rusty brown, I think. So yeah. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number two. Look number two. And I want to play with the purple today. Purple and maybe also the green, because I am feeling like it. And I'm going to start with a color called Tulip, which is the purple. And I'm going to pack it first on the outer corner and then work it in. That's the plan. So let's see how it... I haven't tapped off my brush because I haven't done my face, so it does not really matter. And I want maximum impact. Now my base is still tacky. But I want the most of the purple. So let's blend it out. I'm basically kind of doing circles in. And it pulls in nicely in the crease, so that is good. Just make sure it's a little bit blended here on the eyelid as well. Yeah, I will fix that angle later. It does not really matter that much. I want it underneath my eye as well. And that is the nice thing. If you don't do your base first, you can be kind of messy, you know. Let me get my NYX Glitter Primer. Oh. And a flat brush. I actually cannot wait to see how they perform on the glitter primer. Because I haven't used that method yet. And then here on where I have shadow, just on the border, I'm going to tap a little. But I also have a little bit left wanted here. Then I'm going to go into the color Hyacinth. It's going to go on my upper lid. Oh, this goes on top of the primer so, so nicely. Very smooth. Oh, gorgeous. And then I'm going to fade with whatever I have left on the brush. Just kind of going to go back and forth. Grabbing a little bit extra to pull on top of the matte. Very cute. Now I want a different color there, I think. I think I want that green there, because I think that will be fun. So let me grab a tiny brush. I have a little bit of glitter primer there, so I'm going to stamp it in the color Caterpillar, which is the green. Okay, but I do want, I think, a heavy pink. Yeah. What I'm going to do, because I kind of want a sparkly bit there as well, that flat brush I just used, I'm going to go into the color called Carnations, this one. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to put that on my lower lash line. And just whatever I have left, I'm just going to put on the outer corner. I think that's cool. I do want that purple a little bit deeper, so I'm breaking to the color Tulip, the purple matte. I'm going to really pack it on. I'm also going to work it a little bit more deeply into the crease. Let's take a fluffy brush and blend the top edge a little. So I think this is it so far. I'm going to do the same on the other eye, and then I'm going to do my base, liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Liner, mascara and face is on. I needed to think. And here is the look just before the falsies. Wow. What I did end up doing though was a little bit of the color Blossom, and that I have as a highlight. I also kind of put as an inner corner highlight. And I think it's really, really cute, nice and bold. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab some bold falsies. So yeah, I'm going to do that, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the final look. Everything is on and here is the finished look. I actually forgot how much fun it is to wear very bold and dramatic falsies. I haven't worn these in ages. So yeah, they are the style Kylie that I got at Primark. They are cut quite short, so they are more to the back of my eye. But yeah, I kind of like the dramaticness. So I think next time I'm at Primark, I will grab me a new pair. Because I do really like very, very bold dramatic falsies every once in a while. So yeah, guys. The lippy I paired it with is one from AOA Studio. A Wonder Matte in the color 2034 Echo, and it is a little bit of a pinky purple, something along those lines. So yeah, this is look number 2, nice and bold and dramatic, just like me today apparently. Let me know down below what you think of it, and let's get ready for the last look. The last look with the spring palette, and let's see if we can kind of create something soft. I am actually going to start with the color called Charmed to kind of basically set my eyeshadow base with a very fluffy brush. And I also want it underneath. Again, I put primer on my face this time as well, and concealer, so I can kind of work underneath my eye as well. Okay, so it's still a little bit tacky, but that does not matter. I'm going to go to a brush that's slightly smaller but still fluffy in the same color. I'm going to place this high in the crease, so on my brow bone. I'm also placing a little bit in the crease itself. And again, this is just a base layer, a first light dusting of eyeshadow. With the same brush that I have now, I just kind of cleaned it on my towel. I'm going to go into the color Saint Valentine. And again, I want a light layer, so I'm going in with the fluffy brush. I'm dipping my brush in. And then I'm tapping it off. I'm looking down and I'm placing it low in the crease where my natural shadow is. That's where I place it. Now, if you have hooded lids, you can still do this, but you need to kind of sketch out your eyelid. Or maybe use a brush that is something like this, you know, very, very small and fluffy. This is the Morphe M562, but I think that Sigma also has one of those. But I'm just going to slowly build up the color, and I'm going to have the most intensity here on the outer corner. So that's where I place the shadow first. And then I'm kind of working it in with circular motions. But I'm not going past this part. I also want it on my lid, so I'm still the same brush. I'm going to tap it on my lid and then kind of swipe it in. Let's kind of, I have no extra product, but I want to blend up a little just to make sure that everything is nice and soft. Okay, I want a little bit of depth without adding to the hotness of the pink. Let's grab a small brush and the color called Tulip. And I'm going to deepen up that outer corner just a tiny bit. Let's see if I can though, again without adding a hot pink. Because I still want to keep it nice and soft today. But yeah, it's kind of mute already, isn't it? Really. I'm going to work it in the crease as well. I'm just really blending those two colors together. So I'm going to grab my NYX Glitter Primer. And I'm kind of making a faux cut crease. And the faux cut crease is just basically that line that I'm creating now. A little bit of a sharper line. That is what I want. Okay, now I'm going to go into a very, very fallouty shade, which is Blossom. And that is going to go on top, because I'm actually really curious as well to see how this one works with a glitter primer. I'm going to start here, I'm just going to press, basically press and then drag a tiny bit, instead of just pressing. I'm just taking my time building this up. And now that I use it on top of a glitter primer and grab small bits at a time, the fallout is okay. It's minimum, actually. And then here I'm just tapping over pink a bit. I'm actually going to grab the shade next to it called Amore, this one. And that's going to go there. Oh, that's such a cute shade. And then I'm going to pat it a little bit over. Wiggle a little. I have here an eye pencil from Catrice. It is an inside eye pencil, color and contour in bright lavender, and it is kind of an iridescent, well, lavender. And I'm pulling it on top of my bottom lid. And then I'm going to place the color Hyacinth on top. Just underneath the lashes. Or at least that's what I'm trying to. And also a little bit up to connect it. I'm going to go into the color Saint Valentine, this one, very, very lightly. And I'm running it underneath just to help kind of tie all the colors in a little. Let's grab face powder because I wanted to keep it soft. I'm going to blend with that. Let's put a little bit of that Hyacinth color that that I have there here as well. A little in the inner corner. Something like that. Let me replicate that on the other eye, or at least try to. Finish off the face, put on liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Here is the look just before the falsies. Highlighter is from the palette, and actually the blush is also from the palette, because that's the color Amore. So I have a nice shimmery blush on top of my, well, basically powders, and the rest will all be down in the description box. I'm going to put on falsies. I don't want to keep it a little bit more light, so I will probably use my Londons that I wore in the first look as well. So let me do that. Choose a lippy, and then I will be back to give you also kind of my final opinion on the palette. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere.
One debt to society later.
Is that it? Yeah, it's going to be it. Everything is on, and here is the finished look. I don't know if I succeeded in keeping it light pink or soft pink. But it is what it is. I do really, really like it. So yeah, the lippy I paired is actually a combination. It is Jeffree Star's Velour Liquid Lipstick in the color Can't Relate. And on top of that, the Luxe Lip Gloss in... I actually don't know this color. So this is the combination that I have on. The falsies are my natural ones from Primark. And the rest will be down in the description box.
Oh.
So let me give you my overall final thoughts on the palette. There isn't that much difference between the first impression, the swatches, and now. The shadows layer very, very nicely. They blend out super easily. It does not matter if you put them on a sticky base or on a set base. They just work beautifully. This shade, Blossom, is very fallouty. But I already knew that and I already said that. Although, if I put it on top of a glitter primer, it is the least fallouty of them all. And then just, you know, do in small sections, or just do your eyes first like I did, and then you can wipe away any fallout that you might have. I still wish that I had a deeper shade in here, and I actually wish that this purple was more blue purple and darker, so that you have a very good color gradient between these two. That is my only wish. For the rest, yeah, I really like the palette. I think that the looks that I created with it are very, very cute. That is it, guys. I actually really want to pair it with the winter palette as well, to kind of, I don't know, make maybe a little bit of a springy, happy, grungy look, or something along those lines. Let me know if that is of interest to you. Let me know if you have the palette, if you want the palette, and all that. Don't forget, I have a discount code that is affiliated with 5050 Makeup. It is down in the description box, but it is Nikki10. It will save you 10%. And don't forget to pick your charity at checkout as well. That was it. Those were my three looks with the new spring palette by 5050 Makeup. Let me know if you have a favorite, and that was it. I'm going to sign off. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.